Hi guys, welcome to Catchup Plus on AFOREVO TV, where we bring you entertainment, gossip, take a look into the world of sports and tech. I'm your girl, Abavichon. Let's take a look at some of the trending stories. All right, guys, let's take a look at the first story. Now, Rick Ross was on fire at his Rick Ross Live concert in Lagos a few days ago. While the rapper was performing one of his popular tracks, Blowing Money Fast, Cubana chief priest made it rain, ensuring that every decibel clips of Naira bills continuously flew in the air. Now, after a few minutes, Rick Ross returned the gesture by throwing cash into his pocket, putting his hand in his pocket and throwing cash towards the patrons, and at which cost a little bit of a fine because people was scrambling for the money. Now, popular singers Davido, Tiwa Savage, Mayo Kumpato Ranking, and Remy were among the headliners who threw music lovers. In some other news, the mother of 10-year-old female in the alleged sex video trending online says her daughter was raped after being forced to take a substance by her schoolmates. She also alleged that the school authorities knew about the sex tape and kept it away from her for over a month. And during this period, the school authorities conducted pregnancy tests on her daughter and even warned her never to tell her mom what had happened in Dubai. The management of Chrisland Schools Lagos is now denying claims it conducted a pregnancy test on said a student. Meanwhile, the Lagos Police Command has reacted to the sex video scandal involving the student who were in Dubai for a sporting competition when they had a Trudeau Day session. The state police command says it is also investigating the purported video and also the allegation of threat to life made by the mother of the victim. Now, in the meantime, the school has been shut down pending outcome of the investigation. In Lagos, Owambes are always fun and spray money on people as they dance has become a mainstream culture. But what happens when fun becomes total madness? All right, then this next story is rather bizarre, should I say, weird. Four men have been arrested for allegedly raping a Bengal monitor lizard at a tiger reserve in India. According to reports, the four men were hunters, were arrested after one of the accused phones was discovered to contain a video of them gang raping the lizard. Forest guards initially only caught one of the accused while the others fled. Now, the remaining three were later found in a nearby village. Now, the forest guards are noted that they will take up the matter with the Indian Penal Code court to discuss the charges against the suspect. The world's richest man, Elon Musk, has revealed that he is homeless and says he stays with friends. Now, the Tesla and SpaceX mogul revealed that he hardly spends any time off of his money on material things and only bought a plane so he can spend more time working. In an interview, Musk says that he does not own a single house, even in his base of Texas or near Tesla's San Francisco headquarters. Instead, the businessman, who is estimated to be worth over 200 billion pounds, chose to make use of his many friends' guest room house. Well, I guess there's always another way of living. What are your thoughts on that story? Leave a comment right down below. A man from Florida has reclaimed his world record for the most cinema productions attended of the same film after he saw the latest Spider-Man film in theaters 292 times. Now, Romero Alanis has spent 272 hours, which is equal to 30 whole days watching Spider-Man No Way Home over the course of 3 months to set his record. Now, in order for each viewing to be counted towards the record total, the Guinness Book of Records says he wasn't permitted to look into his phone or to use the bathroom during the duration of the film, including all the credits. Alanis had to submit his cinema ticket as proof of viewership, as well as statement from a theater attendant confirming he watched the film throughout. Amina Moradi, the lady caught in the cheating rumors allegations against Rihanna's boyfriend A$AP Rocky, has finally broken her silence. Moradi, who is famous shoe designer, took to her Instagram stories where she laughed up the rumors, saying she initially assumed it was fake gossip but decided to clear the air and the reports, given that the fact that we live in a society that is so quick to speak on topics regardless of factual basis, and that nothing is off limit. In this next story, we all know that rainy season is here and some areas are badly affected, like the viral video of a business that a businessman posted online lamenting on the state of the road at Jankara market in Lagos State, Nigeria.
The state of Jankara in Jumagu. This is what we have been facing for the past 7 years now. Look at everywhere. You can see. This is everywhere. Each time it rains.
That's it. Let's take a look at what's happening in the world of sports. Now, Manchester City have reportedly agreed into terms with Erling Haaland to make him English Premier League's highest paid player. Haaland is currently one of the most sought-after players in the world. And since joining Borussia Dortmund from Red Bull's Salzburg, he has scored 82 goals in 85 appearances in all competitions. It appears that City have now moved into pole position in the race to make Haaland their star striker, with Daily Mail reporting that the Premier League table toppers have made a significant step in their pursuit. There are claims, however, that Manchester City is ready to pay the 21-year-old a weekly wage of £500,000, taking him above Cristiano Ronaldo. Manchester United star Cristiano Ronaldo has lost his baby son. Now, the sad news was revealed in a message from the couple that appeared on Man U and Portugal forward Ronaldo's social media account yesterday. It read, "It is our deepest sadness. We have to announce that our baby boy has passed away. It is the greatest pain that any parent can feel. Only the birth of our baby girl gives us the strength to live this moment with some hope and happiness. We would like to thank the doctors and nurses for all their expert care and support." Ronaldo will not a feature for Manchester United in their Premier League game against Liverpool tonight due to the tragic news. A rematch has been expected since the turn of the year, and only a few details need to be ironed out. Eddie Hearn has stated that Anthony Joshua's rematch with Oleksandr Usyk has all been agreed upon. The pair fought last September in North London when the Ukrainian pulled off an impressive win in a huge upset, claiming the IBO, IBF, WAB, and WBC heavyweights belt. Now, Joshua then exercises the rematch clause with a second fight expected in spring 2022, but after the rumors of a step aside deal that allow Usyk to go back straight to fight WBA champion Tyson Fury and the Russian invasion of Ukraine, everything seemed to have been halted indefinitely. All right, and some family on one news, an 11th-hour roadblock has been thrown in front of the next month's inaugural Grand Prix in Miami. The Spanish-language Loca El Nuevo Herald newspaper reports that a group of residents have filed a last-minute lawsuit to stop the event from going ahead on the grounds of intolerable noise levels. EEFE, a news agency, claims a judge will hear the case in the coming days about the new Formula One race to take place around the Hard Rock Stadium. All right, before I go, congratulations to Regia Dominique. She just did her traditional wedding, right, guys? You know what to do. Make sure to click on that subscribe button and notification button. And also, be kind enough to follow us on all our social media platforms right there on the screen. Thanks for watching Catchup Plus on AFOREVO TV. I'm your girl, Abebe Jones, signing out.